Hola y bienvenidos a mi canal. Me llamo Dayaneli Iniguez y si quiere saber cómo hacer este look, entonces nomás quédate mirando mi video. Hi guys, it's Dayaneli Iniguez and welcome back to my channel. If you want to know how to recreate this beautiful Valentine's Hill look, then just keep on watching. Okay, so I did my brows off camera and I also primed my eyes with the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot. For today's look, I'll be using the Modern Renaissance palette by ABH. So let's get started. With a Wet n Wild fluffy brush, I'm just gonna take this shade up here and put it on the crease. I'm just gonna put it very lightly. Okay, and then with my Morphe M4 41 brush, I'll be taking Love Letter that is up here and just putting it all over the crease. My Morphe M433, I will be grabbing Love Letter again, but just really focusing it in the inner and then the outer of the eye. Okay, then with the exact same brush and the exact same steps, I'll be taking this shade right here. And then just because I really want to deepen this eye look, I will be going in with the Mani MUA Makeup Geek palette. I'll be going with this shade right here, which is called Mars. Now with my Shape Tape concealer, I'll be cutting the halo eye with my Morphe M224 brush. And I'm just gonna cut it just like this. Use a fluffy flat brush, but I cannot find mine. I don't know where it's at. But I'm just gonna use this small BH brush. And where I cut my concealer, I will be taking this little shimmery shade. No, Primavera, sorry, this one right here. And just applying it all where I put the concealer. This look, you can use any gold shimmery shade or just use this one from the palette, but I really want to intensify my look, so I will be going in with the Desi and Katie shadows. I'll be going in with Zeus, which is this shade right here. I tried it with the look that I posted on Instagram and you can tell what I really digged in there, so let's do it. I grabbed some of my brush. I'm gonna spray some fix lips. This is a beautiful look. I love doing looks like these. They look really fancy. And then to top it off, just because I really want to be really, really extra, and you know, it's Valentine's look, so I just want my man to be like, oh my god, they're shining. I'm gonna go in with the heavy metal glitter and just put it right on top as well. But like, not too much. So I'll put some on there and I'm just dabbing it with my finger.
I want it to look like it's there, but like it's not.
You know what I mean? Don't want to like go too much with the glitter, just to give it a little extra sparkle.
I am 433.
I'm just going in with Love Letter in the red, mixing it a little bit together, and just starting to blend it in to make the halo eye look so seamlessly. So seamless. It. So yes, you guys, this look is very, very easy, very beautiful. I would actually recreate it for Valentine's Day. Still don't know what look I want to do, but this is one of my go-to looks. A halo eye is super easy to do. You don't need a lot of shadows to do it. Basically, you can just use those two and primavera, and that's it. And I call it a look. Put some lashes on, and that's what I'm gonna be doing. So let me do the other eye off camera. Put some lashes on, and I'll be right back. Okay, so I already applied my lashes. I did my other eye off camera, and y'all already know I have really big pores. So I'm gonna go in with my professional. Okay, and then I'll be going in with my Smashbox primer. This is really good for oily skin or oily parts of your skin. Really recommend it. And for the rest of my face, I'll be going with the Smashbox Water Primer. Love Smashbox primers. And today, I wanted to use something new for you guys. And I got this Diamond Beauty sponge from Marshall's. It was $4, because I know that sometimes we don't have money to ball on makeup or whatever, so I want to try it out for you guys. It's this little container and it was $4. Marshall's positive. So let's try it out. I usually use a brush when I do my stick foundation, but I really want to test it out, see if it works or not. So let's check it out. Today I'll be going in with my Hourglass foundation. She cares about his money in the city where she's from. Her intention is the paper, she don't need no fucking love. She's spilling all this liquor, try to pass me all these cups. Well, baby girl, I'm torn, and somebody should have told her. Okay, after I beat up my face with foundation, look at it now. I don't know how I feel. They say this foundation is really good, except the thing is that it's not full coverage, and people claim that it is, and that's an issue for me. It might look full coverage in the camera, but in person it is not. So I'll be going one more layer. I wouldn't say I would really recommend it for stick foundation. So let's try it out with the concealer and see if I can give my opinion about it. But this is a no, this is the foundation. So I'm just gonna go in with my Sigma F-Infused brush. This is awesome for stick foundation, and I'll be right back.
All I care about is money and the city that I'm from. Singing until I feel it. I'ma go until it's done. I don't need to say what's up, but my excuse is that I'm young. I'm only getting older. Somebody should have told you I'm on one.
So there you go, I did it with the brush and it just looks really good. Now it looks full coverage. I would have an issue with my concealer because it has a pink undertone. I did not like it, you know, I was trying to use the best and most of it. I just had to switch it up. So now I still use this Tarte Shape Tape. I just use it in light sand. And then for contour, I'll be going with my Kat Von D contour. To contour the face, I'll be taking my E3 brush. I feel like this is really precise on where you want your contour, so I've been obsessed with this brush lately. Okay, and then for blush, I will be going in with Illuminoso by Milani. It's a pretty pink shade. And for highlight, I'll be going in with the Desi Katie collection. And then for lips, I'll be going with Sugar Plum from Huda Beauty. And to melt the product all in my face, I'll be going in with the MAC Fix Plus. Then set my face with the Morphe Setting Spray. Okay, so this is it for the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you do recreate it, do not forget to tag me, and I will see you on my next video. Bye.